That is a continuation of the series of these anatomy videos. We are going to describe or continue the description of the arterial supply of the gut. We have described before the celiac trunk for the foregut. The superior mesenteric will be for the mid gut, and the inferior mesenteric will be the artery of the hind gut. Let's start by the superior mesenteric, the artery of the mid gut, which starts from the middle of the second part of the duodenum up to the junction between the right 2/3 and the left 1/3 of the transverse colon. That is a cadaveric specimen showing that is the celiac trunk of the foregut, and here is the superior mesenteric artery, the artery of the midgut. As you can see, it's coming from the abdominal aorta behind the body of the pancreas at the level of the lower border of the first lumbar vertebra. While being behind the body of the pancreas, it is crossed by the splenic vein and it crosses the left renal vein, which should be entrapped between that artery and the aorta, affecting the flow of the blood of the left renal vein with the left gonadal vein, which may result in varicosities of the genital veins. Leaving the body of the pancreas from under the body, appearing in front of its uncinate process. That is the uncinate process here. That is the head of the pancreas, and that is the neck of the pancreas marked by the gastroduodenal artery. Here it will come in front of the uncinate, then cross in front of the third part of the duodenum, that is the third part of the duodenum, that is the second part of the duodenum, that is the first part, going up at the fourth part, then the duodenal flexure to join the jejunum, that is the parts of the jejunum. On the right side of the artery is the superior mesenteric vein. Now, as it comes out from front of the third part of the duodenum, it will join the root of the mesentery of the small intestine, which starts from the duodenal flexure down to the ileocecal junction. Here is the abdominal aorta, that is the left renal vein. The spleen will be over here and the splenic vein will be passing above. So that is the superior mesenteric, which trap the left renal between it and the abdominal aorta. Then it will cross the third part of the duodenum, that artery. Within the root of the mesentery of the small intestine, the two layers here, it has the superior mesenteric vein on the right side, as we have seen it in the previous specimen. It will start to cross with the root, the third part of the duodenum, the abdominal aorta, the inferior vena cava, the right psoas, and the structures related to it, which are the gonadal vessels, the ureter, and the genitofemoral nerve. Crossing these structures with the psoas major, it will reach the right iliac fossa. As you can see here, that is the position of the superior mesenteric as it curves in front or pass in front of the third part over here. It will be in front of the abdominal aorta, in front of the inferior vena cava, in front of the ureter, the gonadal vessels, the genitofemoral, and the right psoas major, where it will end in the right iliac fossa. That is the course of the superior mesenteric artery. Here is another specimen showing the pancreas, the transverse colon pulled down, that is the stomach up here, just to show the branches of the superior mesenteric. The first branch will be the middle colic, that is the middle colic artery here, which will pass through, that is the vein, which will be accompanied by the artery, through the transverse mesocolon to supply the right 2/3 of the transverse colon. That's what we can see over here, that is the left colic flexure, that is the liver, the gallbladder, that is the duodenum with the second, third, and fourth parts here. So on the right side, this is a diagram to show those branches, which are the middle colic, the inferior pancreatico-duodenal, the right colic, and the iliocolic, and the jejunal and ileal branches. In that branch here, in that cadaveric specimen, the very clear one is the middle colic vessels. Here, another specimen showing that is the gastroduodenal artery dividing into right gastroblock and superior pancreaticoduodenal between the head of the pancreas and the duodenum. Here will be the inferior pancreaticoduodenal, which comes from the superior mesenteric artery, that is the superior mesenteric artery over here. Then it will, each of the superior and the inferior pancreaticoduodenal will be lying between the head of the pancreas and the duodenum and dividing into two branches, one anterior to the head and one posterior to the head, where all of them will be smoothing each other, supplying the duodenum, the midgut part of it, and the head of the pancreas. We can see here the left kidney. We can see the left renal vein here. We can see the ureter going down. We can see some of the branches of this celiac trunk, the splenic and the common hepatic, the spleen, the liver, the gallbladder. The cystic artery is very clear over here as a branch from the right hepatic artery. That is another specimen just to show the jejunal branches and the ileal branches. The difference between the jejunal and the ileal branches is those types of arcades. Each of these arteries will divide into two, which unite to form an arcade. Those arcades are few in the jejunum, while the straight arteries coming from these arcades are long and they are more vascular, or the jejunum itself is more vascular than the ileum, while or where those jejunal ileal arteries here, these are the jejunal, this is the ileal, will again divide into branches, form arcades, another arcade, a third arcade, a fourth arcade. But in the jejunum, there's only one or two maximum arcades. Here will be several arcades, up to four arcades. From these terminal branches, as we can see, the straight arteries will come out to supply the intestine. Those jejunal straight arteries are larger, are longer, and more numerous, while those ileal will be short and less numerous. That is a summary of the branches of the superior mesenteric artery. As we can see here, that is the middle colic going to the transverse colon. That is the right colic, or these are the two branches actually of the middle colic, which is this one, right, left branch and right branch. That is the right colic artery, and that is the iliocolic artery. These are the jejunal, and these are the ileal branches. So these are the branches of the superior mesenteric. From the main trunk will come acetal arteries, which one is anterior cecal and one will be posterior cecal artery. From that posterior cecal, an appendicular artery will go to supply the appendix. So this is the appendicular artery, that is the anterior cecal, that is the posterior cecal, ileal, jejunal, iliocolic, right colic, middle colic, inferior pancreatic duodenal. These are the branches of the superior mesenteric. Now let's go to the inferior mesenteric, the artery of the hindgut, which starts from the juncture between the right 2/3 and the left 1/3 of transverse colon to the junction between the upper 2/3, the endodermal part, and the lower 1/3 ectodermal part of the anal canal. That is a cadaveric specimen showing those inferior mesenteric artery, that is the inferior mesenteric artery here. It comes from the abdominal aorta again and from the front at the level of the third lumbar, which is crossed by the third part of the duodenum. So it will come behind the third part of the duodenum. Then it will descend downwards and to the left, as you can see here. First, in front of the ureter, that is the kidney will be over here, and the ureter will be first behind it, and then it will become on its right side, that is the ureter. Will be crossing the left common iliac artery, as you can see, to enter between the two layers, the medial two layers of the pelvic mesocolon, to the level of the third sacral piece, where it will continue at the superior rectal artery. So behind the third part of the duodenum, in front of the abdominal aorta, crossing the ureter, which is deep to it, then on the left side of the ureter, then crossing the left common iliac branch of the aorta to the medial lip of the transverse sigmoid mesocolon to the level of the third piece of sacrum, it becomes the superior rectum. That is another good one specimen, that is the abdominal aorta, that is the artery here, that is the inferior mesenteric, giving the upper left colic, the lower left colic, branches or sigmoid, and continuing at the superior rectal. So these are the branches of the inferior mesenteric. The upper left colic, which will divide, ascend upwards on the substance of the psoas major, and then divide into right branch and left branch. The right branch will anastomose with that of the middle colic, while the left branch will anastomose with the first sigmoid branch. The sigmoid are usually three branches or two, which go downwards on the posterior abdominal wall to supply both the descending colon and the sigmoid colon. The branches will anastomose above with the descending branch of the left colic and below with that of the superior rectal artery, which is the continuation of this artery here, the inferior mesenteric. The superior rectal artery will continue downwards to the pelvis, starting at the third piece of sacrum, as you said, to divide into two branches, which should descend on each side of the back of the rectum. These two branches will pierce the muscular coat of the rectum and descend between the muscular and the mucous coat. At the level of the internal anal sphincter, they anastomose with each other, forming loops around the lower end of the rectum and communicating with the middle and inferior rectal arteries. The continuation of this superior rectal will be seen in the anal canal, forming the anal columns, which will be in the upper two-thirds of the anal canal, the endodermal part, or the hindgut part of the anal canal, will be supplied the mucosa mainly by the superior mesenteric, while the mucosa will be by the middle rectal and the inferior rectal. Both of them are not arteries of the gut. It is only the superior rectal artery of the hindgut, which is the lining mucosa of the hindgut. That is about the branches of the inferior mesenteric artery. This set of anastomoses between the superior and the inferior mesenterics, which are responsible for the supply of the large gut, will form a sort of a marginal artery at the mesenteric border of the colon down to the rectum, starting from the main trunk of superior mesenteric, anastomosing with the descending branch of the iliocolic, ascending branch of the iliocolic with the descending of the right colic, ascending of the right with the middle colic, the left, the right branch, the left branch middle colic with the ascending branch of the left colic, descending with the sigmoid of the left colic with the sigmoid, and then descending of the sigmoids with the superior rectal. That's what we call it, the marginal artery, up, up, down, down, to reach the rectum. And that's all about the blood supply of the whole gut, the celiac for the foregut, the superior mesenteric for the midgut, the inferior mesenteric for the hindgut. And now this is the end. So thank you.